Sorry about that. Okay, so I'm gonna record this since we're gonna do the tech tree of choices, but let's just use the Google Drive, just a cloud editable doc, because we can edit that both in real time. So we can add the different choices as we go. Does that work?
Okay, and then describe it in text and compile some kind of figure later.
Yeah, what I'm thinking is literally a tree, so I'm going to say D3D tech tree of choices that we'll share with you. Yeah, a good way is...
Minutes. Seems like my internet connection is too unstable. I'll just take a minute to see what I can do.
Maybe, yeah.
It's better that we just...
Do you want to turn off the video?
If we use text, it will be more reliable.
Let's turn off the video.
Yeah.
Yeah, just turn off the video then. And that might be better. Have you gotten, so look into your email and you should have gotten a link to the, well, let me just paste that.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, a slide. Okay.
Yeah, so, I mean, we can just go right in here. And do something like, so this with dark green, transparent, and white text. X, so, you know, let's just start putting in then. So each, let's make each item a part, a choice, and this would go into the category of frame, you know, so we both break it down into parts and see how each one of them can be implemented. So here's the frame. One aspect is XYZ beam frame. Like, we can get specific on that. We can say, you know, like, I mean, we can get as specific as we like, but we should go for the general categories. Like, what are the type of frames that people use? XYB frame. Some people use a plate frame, like the box frame, like plates. What do you call it? Box frame.
You mean materials, or you mean coordinate system?
Structure.
Separate,
structure. How is structure achieved? So here we have to start first thinking about what are all the different elements. So there's structure. There's the bed. There's the print head. There's a spool, extruder. Geometry, like geometry would be delta, would be rectangular.
Okay.
For structure, I would say hanging printer, you know, like hang printer.
Yeah.
What other variations are there? Square tubing, round tubing. But that's like the XYZ beam frame. That would be a subcategory like right there. Square tubing or round tubing. Maybe.
Yeah. Structure is a bit hard because they don't have names for basic designs yet.
Right.
I usually refer to them as a prism shape, that's Mendel type, and you have Smart Friends Smart Wrap. It has like a tower or cross in the Z direction and the X direction.
Send a link to that. Let's maybe we can put links into each one of those to give examples.
Yeah. Call it a standing cross or something.
So extruders could be direct extrusion.
Bowden an extrusion, and then you have. Flex drive extrusion.
Each one uses stepper motors, nobody uses anything else?
There has been quite a lot of experimentation with the DC motors and with the feedback system. That was used before stepper motors got popular. Blue and green didn't work very well.
Here, so do that. So there, I'll show you, do this. No, just leave that crack alone. How about that?
Okay.
So yeah, I know that there's...
Did you change the link color to white?
Yeah, I did.
Yeah, okay. Good.
Smart wrap, so that's a... Oh, wow. Yeah. Oh, man. Does that work? Is that well proven?
It works, but it's only good for very small printers.
But, so I'm thinking, like, once again, how do we achieve the three dimensions if you do modularity? Because you put the X... Put the x-axis on top of the y-axis, under the y-axis, and you've got R specifications for motion, static platform, right?
Yeah.
But you can scale that to any dimension. That's scalable, as far as it looks.
You get a heavy y-axis because you carry the whole x-axis. But then again, you have two motors for the y-axis.
Yeah, that's. I think that's. Yeah, I think that's fine. You just need more power on, just more power. I mean, but that's like, wow, that's, you know, that's complexity-wise, that is the way to go. That's like 100% modular there, right? X, Y, Z are identical. Oh, man.
Yeah, exactly. I plan on having a standard interface for every linear actuators, and the possibility of mounting and demounting the thing that actually moves without disassembling the smooth rods and all that stuff. So I'll use linear bearings that you can disassemble.
If those are the smooth rods, where's the drive? How is that driven? That's, oh man, that is...
What picture are you looking at?
Wow, that's, I like, oh man, that is, yeah, I, huh. The bearings that you can take in and out, I like that.
Yeah.
Oh wow.
I had some, I was consulted by a friend earlier today. She showed me some CNC machines that used that solution.
Hmm. I mean, from the modularity standpoint, that's attractive, very attractive, because you can scale that infinitely. You can put more bearings. Oh, wow. I like that.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's very nice. So that's a nice standing cross.